Hello, good evening. Well, good day, I should say, because we're going live middle of the day, 3 o'clock, weird little time. But I've just done a quick Google Hangout with the Marsden's brigade and everything, and they've got an extraordinary lovely beer, a really, really beautiful beer. This is Pedigree, Marsden's Pedigree. I don't know if you can see that. One minute, let's get it out of the light a little bit. Pedigree New World. It's terrible in that light. Really lovely label, but you can't really see it there. I'm working off the live camera and everything else, so, you know. Poured this already, but I'm going to re-pour. I don't know how much bottle conditioning we're going to get. Possibly the slightest of a sliver in the bottom of the glass. So, just going to re-pour a little bit in there just to get the head going again. And show you what we've got. We've got sunshine in the glass. My 1985 GBBF glass has kind of rarely been so kind of sunshiny. It is really lovely. Sunshine in the glass, little spattering of clouds overhead. That is lovely. Just the day for cricket, that is. This is a kind of commemorative beer for the, I believe it is anyway, for the Ashes. I could be wrong. I was kind of weren't getting it all in that, you know. But this is New World Pale Ale. Now, any similarities to Marsden's Pedigree? I'm kind of not sure, because Marsden's Pedigree is nice and everything else, you know. But it's got very different flavours, very, very different flavours. This has got some big punch in Australian hops. In particular, it's got a Tasmanian hop called Galaxy. And if any of you've ever tasted it, it's a beauty, an absolute beauty. Now they're kind of dry hopping a lot more than they would usually with other beers and things like that. Not sure if they're kind of using the Burton Union system of all their things. I think they do that with other beers, and I think they do that with Pedigree. Not too sure, not certain. They also do a double drop system as well, which has things to do with yeast and God knows what else. But I'm going off the remit a little bit. I'm going to give this a little twirl on the smell and see if I can tell you quickly, because my reviews do get a bit long, quickly what we've got. We've got a very sparkly looking beer, very sparkly kind of going for it beer. And the hops are very, very much the stars of the show. They've kind of reined back the malts. They've got a little bit of pale malt, probably Marisotter or something like that. And the big stars of the show are the hops. Massive, big, punchy hops. As I say, a lot of dry hopping. Dry hopping, basically, it's nothing to do with how dry the hops are. It's just a kind of later hopping. And they go into a cooler wort or a cooler beer, sort of, let's say. They go into a cooler thing. They can go in to the fermenter, but they quite often will go in the cask. And, you know, and then be bottled up after or whatever. But if they're going to ferment, they're in a little tea bag thing, or in Sierra Nevada's case, they've got a torpedo. It's a big, like, rude-looking shape, you know. Anyway, I do digress again. Kind of excited by a really lovely beer here. Let's give it a smell and see what I can tell you about it. Massive, massive, massive pink grapefruit in there. Really punching, lovely grapefruit. A grapefruit that's kind of, that doesn't need loads of sugar on it, but at the same time is still a bit spiteful, a bit, you know, a little bit acidy and naughty, you know, but nice, you know, kind of breakfast, that breakfast juice you get with the grapefruits, nice little bit of, instead of orange, something like a, what's the tangerine, no, the little tight one, Satsuma's probably, yeah. Satsuma's little kind of nice little, almost a floral orange note, like almost a bergamot orange in there. Right, let's have a taste. This is lovely. Oh, it's hardly a sipper, but it has got a bite enough that kind of stops you from gulping at it. This is 4.1, so it's not high on the Richter scale. But with the bite of the hops, it's powerfully hopped. And it kind of tastes quite powerful. It tastes quite strong. Also, that the sedative effects of hops, they're related to cannabis, Cannabisia cerveza or something like that. They're related to cannabis. They have got a sedative effect. So if you've got a very hoppy beer, the ABV will seem higher. It will get you more drunk, you know. So a 4.1 ABV with a very hoppy, resinous, kind of loopy beer, that will kind of have more of an effect on you than say a 5%, something like that. Excuse me. Very hip and cool looking label. Love that. I don't think it's listing the hops on the back, which would be nice, you know. I always say, like, kind of, come on, brewers, just have a bit of a hop and malts, you know, a little list of them. You don't have to say when they go in and everything else. But that would be lovely. But that is a really extraordinarily fine beer, lovely beer. If you kind of are a bit shy, hop shy, now I mentioned to start with, is this to kind of aim at the lager market and that. I kind of think it would scare some of the lager boys and that, because it's very hoppy. And what it does, it's got that finish that I always think a good beer should walk you home hand in hand from the pub. It should kind of should walk you home from the pub and stay with you right up until you knock on the door and Missy's hits you with a rolling pin and that, you know. That's lovely. An exotic pale golden ale. Lovely. Absolutely beautiful. Without a doubt. Bum 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 bum. Try it, buy it, and love it. That's lovely. One of the best things from to come out of Marsden's since their strong ale. Mm. And that's going in my book, that one. See you soon. That looks a bit cloudy, isn't it? It's my glass going a bit like funny. See you soon. Take care. See you in the next one. Don't be late, because I will start without you. Biddly biddly boo.